Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for joining me today, Friday afternoon. Getting ready for soccer season tryouts a couple weeks away. So I figured we get soccer interviews ramped up. And my first up is a senior from Freehold Township, Kelsey Gilroy. Kelsey, thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
First, are you excited, 2 weeks to get back onto the field and get ready for the high school season?
Yeah, I'm definitely excited. I hope the season's normal.
Now, we'll talk a little bit later on about this current season, but the only returning senior, how does that feel being the sole senior on the team right now?
It's a little nerve-wracking because it's like, I feel a lot of pressure, but I think it's exciting too.
Yeah, big graduation class last year, so I wish you luck with all the underclassmen. Getting back, when you were younger, how old were you when you started playing soccer?
I actually started when I was like 3. I used to do those little camps with my mom, but I was pretty young.
Yeah, it seems like soccer, kids start around 3, 4, where other sports, you're a little bit older. So was it like first sport, like first love, like was that your passion from the get-go? Or
yeah, I love soccer, but I played kind of every sport. I also was a big swimmer when I was younger, so
a lot of people's swimming is probably the best sport to keep you in shape, because you're working all your muscles. So you said swimming. What other sports did you do when you were younger?
I played basketball, just rec though. I also did a little bit of softball. I didn't like it. I danced. I didn't like that either. I kind of just stuck with soccer.
It seems like if you're a soccer player, softball gets eliminated pretty quickly because it's a slow pace sport. Mm-hmm. I noticed that with everybody I interviewed, that if you play soccer, softball is like the one sport that you stay away from. Do you have any siblings?
I have one younger brother.
Younger brother, does he play soccer?
Yeah, he plays every sport too, but he's primarily like football and basketball right now.
Okay. How old is, what grade is he in?
He's going to be a sophomore. So he's 15.
At Freehold too. So, and, mm-hmm. So he plays football, you said?
Yes.
So no soccer for high school then?
No.
Okay. Are you two very competitive?
Yeah, we're actually really close. So we kind of battle out like in the backyard all the time.
That's great. Do you always have to make sure you win?
Yeah, of course. I always win.
I like to ask players is, what have your family meant to you and your development? Because I know you're a PDA player that takes a lot of time and money. So how have they helped you?
My parents are, really supportive of me, especially my mom. My mom played D1 basketball on a full ride. So she pushes me a lot to work hard and stuff, and the money's tough for us, so it means a lot that they like put me through PDA all the time every year.
Yeah, my niece is going through it now, and when I used to coach soccer travel, it was $35 a season, and just a regular club team was $600 for the year. I was kind of shocked when I found out how much. Like, it's just crazy how it's changed through the times. So you said your mom was a D1 basketball player. What school did she go to?
She went to St. Francis in Brooklyn.
Okay. All right. They still got a pretty decent basketball program up there. Yeah. They got a couple short kids on that team. Did she play soccer growing up at all, or was it just basketball?
She actually did. She played soccer in high school. She also played every sport. She's very athletic. So
let me, was she disappointed that soccer was your sport and not basketball?
Yes, especially because my mom's only 5'2", and I'm a lot taller than her.
Oh, wow.
She wished I used my height for basketball, but I didn't.
Okay. Growing up, who was, it could be a family member, or professional athlete or whatever, who was a role model?
I know I just talked about her, but honestly, my mom is a huge role model.
Okay.
I would love to follow in her footsteps and play D1, and so...
That's great. Do you remember who your first soccer coach was?
Yeah, Coach Tom. I played for Freehold Flash. I actually played with Ava Madoff. I think she talked about him. So, yeah, he was a great coach.
Okay. How was that, rec or was that a travel team?
It was travel. So, like, the Freehold Travel League.
Okay. Yeah, they've always – Freehold's always – I mean, obviously, you can tell the way Freehold Township High School – their success over the past 10 years in soccer has been, do you, What team did you go to after Freehold?
I went to PDA after. I tried out at a few places. It was actually after Ava left. We didn't have a goalie, so we kind of were all rotating. So I was like, yeah, I can't do that. But PDA is where I ended up, and I stayed there.
And who's your coach now at PDA?
Lou Santa Cruz.
Lou, okay, great. Lou's a great guy. I talked to him. And all those PDA coaches are pretty, you know, I always see them at the soccer high school games supporting, you know, the players of the team, which is great to see. What's your position for Freehold?
For Freehold Township, I play center back, usually. Okay.
Do you play that position for PDA too?
No, I play center attacking mid, usually, for PDA.
That's a pretty big difference, attacking mid to...
it's hard to adjust, but I don't mind.
I noticed that a lot, like, a lot of players play different positions for the high school team. Did you find that adjustment hard or easy?
I actually found it kind of hard. He switched me. I played center back my freshman year, but I was happy with that because I was a freshman and starting. So, but then I played a little bit of center mid my sophomore year, and then he kept moving me back and forth, and I was kind of getting frustrated. but I actually am, like, super happy that I play center back because it's a lot of versatility. I think that's really, you know, good for college. So
that's a pretty good accomplishment, you know, being that the team was such senior heavy that you started, you know, as a freshman. So that's a big accomplishment right there. going into high school, what were some goals you set for yourself that you wanted to achieve over the 4 years?
I definitely wanted to, you know, play varsity, make varsity and start varsity. And, like, coming off a state championship township, that was, like, a, you know, really cool thing. And I would love to win a state championship, and we did last year. So that was a really cool thing to accomplish.
Yeah, we'll talk a little bit about, you know, the run your team had. You know, I was very high on your team, you know, going into the last season. And, you know, unfortunately with the pandemic and everything, we didn't get to have a complete season. But it was a nice run, you know, Freehold made. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned, you know, you're going as a freshman, you wanted to be, you know, varsity starter, which is pretty good. I like to ask kids, going as a freshman could be very nerve-wracking going in there. Did you have any upperclassmen that you were able to look to for, like, support or if you had any issues?
Yeah, I mean, the whole back line were seniors, which was, really helpful. Jess Judge was the other center back, and she really, like, helped me learn the position and, like, kept my confidence up. And Alessia was our goalie, and she was, you know, brought a lot of energy to the field, which was really something that I needed as a freshman. So
do you think that helps a program long term when you got upperclassmen that, you know, help and go, you know, reach, help the underclassmen to be such a successful program like Freeholdsman?
Yeah, 100%. I think we, like, strive off our leaders, so I feel like that's a lot of you know, that's helps our program a lot, like how many good leaders we've had over the past few years.
Yeah. And like we said, you know, Freehold's been so successful over the years. Moving to your sophomore year, what were some goals you set for yourself going into the sophomore season?
Well, Patterson told me that I was going to be playing center mid. So I definitely wanted to be more on the attacking side and kind of lead that position also. I also did want to win a state championship and beat Hunterdon Central because we lost to them. So,
we'll go to that game right now. Actually, we'll talk about that. I was at that game, and, you know, I think they finished number one that season, right? At the end of the season, your two teams met, what was that? Central Jersey, the final, right? The group.
Yes, that year was the final. I'm pretty sure the year before that was semifinal.
What it mean, you know, taking that team to the limit, you know, being, you know, they end up having the, you know, Gatorade player of the year that year, mm-hmm. you know, Emily Mason, but Freehold, you know, you took that team to the limit and they kind of scored on that, you know, to me it was a nonsense call, you know, to win the game, but, you know, it is what it is. But how did it feel playing a team like that so hard?
It was definitely nervous. Like, I was very nervous going in, but I was also really excited. Like, it was really fun playing them the first year, just playing against so many good players who actually, like, I've heard of, and I, like, through, like, PDA and stuff, so that was actually pretty cool. And it sucks that we lost, but, like, we played a really good game, and that was good. So
yeah, like, I was there. It was, first of all, that schools in the middle of nowhere. When I was driving to that game, I was like, where am I going? Rewind a little bit. Talk to short conference tournament, the run the team had, and, you know, you end up losing to Thomas River North in a shootout, which, to me, losing in a shootout, like, there has to be a better way to decide a playoff game in soccer, in my opinion. But just talk to the run you had in that Thomas River North game.
We did great in the short conference. I mean, we obviously made it to the semifinal, and that was a cool game. There were a lot of people there. And I think we were down 1-0 the whole game and ended up scoring. Ryan actually scored. Ryan Leonard scored with, like, literally 3 seconds left. It was the best feeling ever. And then I took the last PK and I missed, and that was one of the worst feelings of my whole life. So,
another game I wanted, that St. Rose game that led you to that, that was a remarkable game. I had that game circled, you know, as soon as the bracket came out. You know, I know St. Rose very well. Talk that game, because that was a back and forth game too. And, you know, I always feel that games like that help, you know, prepare you for the tough state games. Do you agree with that?
Yes, I definitely agree. I remember we were marking up players in the middle, and I had the responsibility of marking, I think her name was Juliana. I'm not sure.
Laskowskis, yep.
Yeah, she was really good, and she's a scorer. So Patterson put me on her the whole game, and she didn't score. So I felt like that was pretty cool. And I think we did so good as a team that game, just keeping our composure. And obviously we won, I think, in overtime. So that really confidence for the rest of the tournament.
That was, you know, that was a very fun game to be at as well. And, you know, I got to see your team quite a bit that season, because I just loved the style, the way your team played. And, you know, and it just attracted me to go to more and more games to watch the team. Do you think, going back to the Hunter and Central, do you think that playing them so well helped set the tone with for your last season with the expectations that, you know, your team, you know, can compete with the best in the state?
Yes, I think that game kind of put in perspective how talented we were as a team, and we weren't losing many seniors from that year, so I think it just gave us even more confidence going into the next year. So
now, going to last season, did you think the season was going to happen?
I actually did. And then when I found out it was going to be shortened, it was actually really disappointing. And, you know, it's not what you want, especially, you know, like playing soccer or playing any sport, like, for your season to be shortened. So that was, you know, but I think we obviously took advantage of it and did the best we could. So,
yeah, that had disappointing, especially with your school had such a heavy senior class, you know, short season. But like you said, you know, you got the season in, and, we'll talk. I want to talk a couple questions before we talk about a couple games. I always see a big improvement, whether it's soccer or basketball, between sophomore and junior season. What was something you were looking to improve on, you know, going into last season?
I think, honestly, like, my attitude on the field and kind of like adjusting to what the team needed. Because, like I said, like, my junior year, I played center back, which is not what I was used to. And I wanted to, instead of, like, getting frustrated about it on the field, kind of just step up and, like, understand that that's a big responsibility, and that we have other players in the center midfield who play with together better. So that was actually something I really wanted to improve on my junior year, and I felt like I did. So it was good.
How did you handle personally, like, the uncertainty whether you might get a phone call, hey, game's canceled, or, you know, even the season might be canceled? How did you handle that?
Well, I think that it just kind of showed how hard we had to work for every game, and you'd never know. It's like, we didn't know if we were going to get canceled, so you might as well win every game. And that's kind of like how I took it. It was definitely like nerve wracking to think, like, tomorrow we can not have a season, especially like when states came. I was really nervous that one of our games were going to be canceled. So,
especially when you see, you know, other schools around, you know, all of a sudden, you know, games being canceled, they're, you know, and no fault to their own either, you know, could just be somebody in the school that might have tested positive. But it was good to see, you know, your team finish out the season. Before we get to the state run, when the schedule came out, Middletown South was in Freehold, where the games I had circled, you know, out of everyone. just talk that series. You know, your two teams ended up splitting. You know, the first game, it was at home, end up unfortunately blowing the lead.
Yeah.
Talk that game first.
I think we just were overconfident, especially scoring those two goals. And then I think we made some adjustments on the field that, like, I don't know. I feel like we kind of just didn't want it as much as they did, mm-hmm. in my opinion. And then the second game, like, no one wanted to lose. That would have been the worst thing in the world. So.
And they were pretty similar games, you know, just, you know, reverse outcome. And they were very fun to watch. You know, and I give you, you know, being honest, you know, you said they wanted it more that first game. And, you know, the start of the second game, your team came out there. Like, Freehold was really attacking. Mm-hmm. Now let's go to the state run. How did it feel, you know, making that run and being able to win that? I don't know, but is it a state title or is it a sectional? I don't know what they're called it last year.
They called it like a central regional or okay. central east, something like that. I don't know what it was. We're going to call it a state title. So, well, leading up to that, we didn't only had a few games, but our big game was East Brunswick. And that was a fun game.
Did that go to a shootout too?
East Brunswick?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
And the year before it did too, didn't they?
Yeah, against Old Bridge, I think.
Old Bridge. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Are shootouts how nerve-wracking, you know, especially come playoff time, you know, it's the, you know, you're either advancing or the season's over. How nerve-wracking is that?
Well, after the Shore Conference loss, I think they're a lot more nerve-wracking for our team. But I don't know. I felt pretty confident going into the East Brunswick shootout because we had a lot of players that really I knew were going to step up, even some underclassmen. It was mostly all underclassmen that took like PKs, which is I actually thought really good, and because I didn't think they would be as nervous as a senior would be, so I thought that was really smart on like our coach. But I felt pretty confident going in, to be honest, and we did well. So
yeah, and you had a couple good, you know, really good underclassmen, you know, Kayla Cassidy and Gabby, right? Nice little court, you know, coming back for this coming season. Moving, you know, to the season, like you said, you know, tryouts is right around the corner. And what are some goals you have set personally for this season?
Just to, I think, be a leader and, you know, lead the team and just like show, I think there's got to be a lot of new varsity players that haven't played varsity, which is not easy. And I think that just like showing how hard you really have to work for your spot is important. And, you know, what it means to be a part of varsity, like, and the team. So
you kind of touched on that. I was going to ask next, what is hoping you pass down to the underclassmen that they carry along with them?
Yeah, I think mostly work ethic. I think that's super important on the field, and your soccer IQ, I think, is just as important as how good you are, like how smart you are with the ball. So I think that's also important. And, you know, just working together as a team and kind of forgetting that we're all different ages is important also.
Yeah, you know, that's another tough part. People don't realize, you know, sometimes I hear parents yelling and screaming, but sometimes, you know, you have 14 and 15-year-olds playing on the field. You know, people got to realize, you know, you're still kids. Just touch, you know, you got some key players coming back. What do you think the outlook is for the season coming up?
I think it's going to be tough to adjust because we don't know a lot of the JV players, but I think that I think the returners are so strong, like, you know, Cassidy, Kayla, Ainsley, Gabby, they all made such an impact last year. And like, that gives me honestly a lot of confidence going into this year. And I think just like, you know, the JV players really got to step up and like, or any players really just have to step up and, you know, make something work on the field.
Yeah, and you like Freehold's so deep, people usually hear, you know, JV players, you know, gotta step, but Freehold was so deep last year, just, you know, with so many seniors that just some of the JV players could have played, you know, on other schools. It just, with the Freehold's roster, just couldn't get on
100%.
get on the field. You up for some rapid fire questions?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. What's your favorite TV show?
Probably Law and Order, SVU.
SVU. I can't believe that show is still going on.
I know.
I actually just started watching, well, a little while ago, Grey's Anatomy. I'm on season 8. And
surprisingly.
I never did either, and somebody got me watching it, and I'm moving along. I can't believe there were 18 seasons of that, too. So yeah. That and Law and Order. It's amazing. Mm-hmm. How about favorite movie?
Probably Breaking Point. It's just a movie that my dad and I watched a while ago.
What's that about?
It's about these guys that try to conquer these like 7 impossible tasks around the world. And it's pretty cool.
Oh, interesting. I'll have to check that out. Favorite food?
I would say sushi.
Sushi? How about a school subject?
Definitely math or bio.
Math, okay. Favorite song? It doesn't have to be a group or, you know, genre if you don't even have...
I don't know if I have a favorite song. Chris Brown is my favorite artist. Okay. Yeah.
Favorite number?
18.
Favorite color?
Blue.
Okay. Last one for this. What is something you enjoy doing in your free time when it's not soccer?
I would say I actually like school, so I like to study, and I like to run too. I like going on runs, so.
That's it. Just the first person that said that you enjoy actually studying.
Yeah.
I got reading sometimes, but never studying.
Yeah, no, I don't like to read, but.
All right. Talk about future. What are some things you're looking at? Looking at schools, like location, size, that kind of stuff.
I definitely don't want to go too far, but I'm looking more up north for my schools. And the size doesn't really matter to me. I think I would like a bigger school, but I'm not opposed to a smaller school either. So
how far north do you think?
Oh, the farthest I've looked is like Boston. Like
it's the Boston area. So beautiful up there. Yeah, can't go wrong up there. Do you know what you want to study?
Yeah, I want to be a pre-med major.
Good luck. You girls are so impressed. So impressive with, you know, being able to play sports at such a high level. I know I probably say this every interview, but like I said, when I was in school, it was either sports or school, and you know, soccer, high level, pre-med, you know, it's so impressive what you kids do these days. So pre-med major, do you know what field you kind of want to go into after college?
I think definitely the medical field. I'm not sure if I want to be a doctor, like go to med school, or do something more like physical therapy. I'm not really sure yet.
Okay. Last question, then I'll let you go. What advice would you give your younger self?
I think maybe not to be so hard on myself. I think I put a lot of pressure on myself to like be perfect, and that's not possible. So I think just kind of enjoying high school more, which I did enjoy it, but I don't know.
So you can't be perfect?
No, unfortunately not.
One question I kind of skipped over is, how has Coach Patterson helped you?
Coach Patterson is a huge help in like so many different aspects. He's my teacher I'm in the IB program at my school, so he's been my teacher the last year, and he's going to be next year. So he helps me academically a lot, and then, you know, for college, he's been like doing a lot for me also. And as a coach, he's taught me, you know, that I have to adjust to the team and how important it is to be like a leader and stuff like that. So
what's that program that you just brought up?
The IB program. It's called International Baccalaureate.
What's that for? Like, yeah, I'm clueless when it comes to that.
It's not every school has it. It's kind of just like a very rigorous program. It's like AP classes kind of, but it's okay. More like you're in a programs, and you also have to do like community service and stuff like that. So
it sounds pretty tough. So on top of that, you're also, you know, this is the senior leader of one of the top soccer teams, you know, in the state. So you have your hands full.
Yeah.
Well, Kelsey, I appreciate you taking some time out today, and I wish you luck, and I'll definitely be catching Freehold this season on the field.
Yeah. Thank you.
No problem, Kelsey. Thank you.